Hello guys, a very good morning to all of you. Now today's the chapter is understanding quadrilaterals. In this chapter, we are not only covering the quadrilaterals, also we cover plane surface, plane curve. Okay, because this is a very basic concept to draw any figure. Okay, so let's start the topic. First one is plane surface. What is plane surface? A flat surface which can be extends in all direction, known as plane surface. Guys, what is the meaning of extends in all direction? That means if you have, this is the plane surface, this is the plane surface. If you want to extend in this, you can extend. This is our solid surface, but if you have a rubber band, a paper, okay, and any unsolid surface, you can extend in any direction. In this direction, 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 or in this direction. Okay. So this is the basically meaning of extends in all directions. Okay, you can extend in any direction. Okay, that is the meaning of plane surface. Okay, this is a plane surface, this is a surface. If you extend this one in any direction, you can say it's a plane surface. Okay, yes or no? You can extend this is again a plane surface. Okay, now second one is plane curve. Now what is the meaning of plane curve? In a plane surface, if a curve is drawn without lifting the pencil. Okay, in a plane surface, if a curve is drawn, or you can say if points are joined, if points are joined without lifting the pencil, okay, known as plane curve. That means, guys, you have many points in a surface. Okay, in a surface, if you start to join all the points, but the condition is without lifting the pencil. Without lifting the pencil means you cannot lift the pencil at the time of joining the points, it will gives you a curve. That curve is known as plane curve. Okay, suppose this is a plane surface, this is the plane surface, and these are points. Okay, point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now M start to join all the points sequentially without lifting the pencil. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so this is a curve. I don't know which kind of curve, but this is a curve, plane curve. Okay, now on the behalf of lifting the pencil, or on the behalf of plotting the curve, we can classify two types of curves. Okay, first is open curve, सेकंड वन इज क्लोज कर्व, ओपन कर्व एंड अ क्लोज कर्व. ओके गाइस, व्हाट इज ओपन कर्व? Guys, the if the first point and the last point cannot join together, okay, that means it will gives you a curve with open the mouth of that curve. Okay, you can see this curve is open mouth. Okay, so you can say it's open curve. Okay. Again open curve, okay, the mouth is open, okay, you can say again the open curve, you can enter in this curve with this side or with this side. So these are the open curve. Now what is closed curve? Can you check? You cannot enter in this curve. You cannot enter in this curve. Okay? Yes or no? That means it's a closed curve, closed entity. These are the closed curves. You can check. You cannot enter in this any one case. Okay, so these are the closed curve. Okay, so plane surface and a plane curve. Okay, now next is now. The next is polygons. What are polygons? First of all, you have to know polygons are always be closed entity, closed curve, always closed curve. Okay? Closed curve made up of line segments are known as polygons. The most important term which is remembered by you is line segment, closed curve but with line segment. Okay, this is a closed curve. This is the closed curve, okay? Closed curve, but not polygon. Closed curve, but polygon. Guys, this is a both of the closed curve, but this one is not polygon and this one is polygon. Why it is polygon? Why it is polygon? Why it is not the polygon? The reason behind it, there is a no line segment. There is a no line segment. Okay, but there are three line segment. 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so number of line segment always equals to vertices. Number of vertices. This is the concept which comes from here. You can check three line segment, three vertices. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Zero line segment, zero vertices. Okay, जीरो लाइन सेगमेंट जीरो वर्टाइसिस, थ्री लाइन सेगमेंट थ्री वर्टाइसिस. ओके नाउ ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ नंबर ऑफ लाइन सेगमेंट वी आर गोइंग टू क्लासिफाई टू द पॉलीगन्स. ओके गाइस, ओके आई विल टेल यू लेटर. Kind of polygon and a figure. Okay, guys, kind of polygon, triangle. Okay, this is E. Triangle. Triangle is three angle with three angles, and the figure is. You cannot join two. Lines. You cannot join two lines. Okay, sorry. You cannot draw a closed curve with the help of two lines. Okay. So there are minimum three line segments are required to draw a closed curve. Okay. Four. Tetragon. Four, or you can say quadrilateral, okay, triangle, tetragon, pentagon means five number of sides, 1, 2, 3, 4 and a 5. Okay, hexagon, 6 number of sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is also known as Banjin shape. Okay, heptagon, 7, octagon, 8, nanogon, 9, decagon, 10. Okay, now guys, from 4, 3 to 10 we will use the prefix gon. Okay, we will use the prefix gon. Okay, similarly for 20 we will use icosagon. Okay, so this is the prefix. This is a pentagon. So penta is the suffix, gon is the prefix. Suffix prefix. Okay, so octagon, nonagon, decagon, icosagon. Okay, so this is the kinds of polygon. This is the first kinds of polygon on the basis of number of sides. Okay, triangular, triangle, pentagon, hexagon, octagon, nonagon and so on. Now we are going to take kinds of polygon on the basis of diagonals. Okay, so before starting kinds of polygons on the basis of diagonals, you should know what is the diagonal. A line segment joining off two opposite vertices which are not on. Same adjacent side. Okay, a line segment which is joined by two opposite vertices, but the condition is both vertices are on the not on the same adjacent sides. Okay, these are adjacent sides AB and AD, BC and AB adjacent side, DC and BC adjacent side. A line segment by joining the opposite vertices 1 and a 2. Yes or no? So this is the diagonal number 1. This is opposite vertices. Look at here. Diagonal number 1, diagonal number 2. Okay, now diagonal number 1 and a diagonal number 2. Okay, this is quadrilateral. This is only four sides. We can easily draw the quadrilateral. We can easily draw the diagonals. But when we have nonagon, when we have decagon, what's about the number of diagonals? This question comes always in Olympiads, KBPY, always, frequently. You find the number of diagonals in pentagon, or find the number of diagonals when you have number of sides 12. Okay, so number of diagonals when we have n number of sides, that is n minus 3 upon 2. Right, this is the formula, n minus 3 upon 2. Okay, if you have n equals to 10 decagon, find the number of diagonals. Okay, 10 minus 3 7 upon 2. There are 35 number of diagonals in decagon. Okay, you can verify from here. N equals to 4, 4 multiplied by 4 minus 3, 1 upon 2. There are only 2 diagonals. Okay, I hope now you understood the concept. Okay, now next is, on the basis of diagonals, find out polygon. We are going to classify the polygon, but on the basis of diagonals. Same in two categories, one is convex polygon, second one is concave polygon. Convex polygon. Now, what is convex polygon? If all the diagonals are drawn inside the polygon, okay, you are going to plot the diagonals in any polygon, but all the diagonals are inside the polygon, not outside. Not outside, all. I am talking about all the diagonals inside the polygon. That's it. It is known as convex polygon. Quadrilateral. Okay, quadrilateral. one diagonal inside the polygon. Okay, pentagon, okay, inside the polygon are the convex polygon. Okay, these are the convex polygon. Second, concave polygon. If any one diagonal can be drawn outside the polygon, if anyone you can draw, suppose in pentagon, in decagon, you can form 35 diagonals. All 34 diagonals can be drawn inside the decagon, but a one diagonal is formed outside the decagon. That time it's a concave. That's why I'm using anyone. Agar ek bhi diagonal polygon ke bahar draw hua hai, that time it's a concave. Otherwise it's a convex. Quadrilateral. Okay. Diagonal number 1 inside the polygon. But the diagonal number 2, outside the polygon. It's a concave polygon. Okay. Now, next is on the basis of angle and sides. On the basis of angle and sign, kind of polygon. First regular polygon. If in a polygon all the angles are equal and all sides are equal, known as regular polygon. Or you can say a polygon has equiangular and equilateral. Equiangular means all angles are equal. Equilateral means all sides are equal. Okay? Yes or no? Example, square. In this square, all sides are equal. Yes or no? All sides are equal. This is the sign of equality. Okay? And each angle is 90 degree. We know that. We know that. All angles are 90 degree. All sides are equal. It's a regular polygon. Next is equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle. All sides are equal. Each angle is 60 degree. 60, 60, 60. So these two are regular polygon. If we are going to talk about irregular polygon, then guys, please understood with the help of example. It's very easy to understand the concept. Irregular polygon. Rectangle. The best example of irregular polygon. Okay, rectangle. Everyone knows in rectangle each angle is 90 degree. That means all angles are equal, 90 90 90 90, but sides are not equal. Only opposite sides are equal. That time we can say it's irregular polygon, not regular polygon. You can say this side is equal to this side. It's easy for you if we do nomenclature. AB equals to CD and BC equals to AD. But AB is not equals to CD, is not equals to DA, is not equals to BC. Means all sides are not equals to each other. All sides are not equals to each other. Only all angles are equal. 90, 90, 90, again 90. Angles are equal, but sides are not equal. That means one condition is failed here. We can say it's irregular. For regular, both of the conditions are compulsion. Compulsion of both of the conditions: equiangular, all angles; equilateral, all sides. Okay, I hope you understood. Now we are going to start our topic, understanding quadrilaterals. This is the basic concepts of curves, polygons. Okay, now in quadrilaterals, quadrilateral, lateral means sides, qua means four. That means qua, a closed curve of four sides. Qua plus lateral, that means qua means sides, sorry, four, lateral means sides. Okay, so four sides is compulsion. Four angles is compulsion. We know the concept. N minus 3 upon 2, number of diagonals 4 multiplied by 3 upon 2, 2 to the 4. Yeah, so 2 multiplied by 1, that means 2 diagonals. Okay, these are the 3 specifications about quadrilateral. Okay, now first, kinds of quadrilateral. फर्स्ट पैरेललोग्राम ओके सेकंड रोम्बस थर्ड ट्रैपेज़ियम एंड लास्ट राइट गाइस दीज आर द फोर काइंड्स ऑफ क्वाड्रिलेटरल पैरेललोग्राम रोम्बस एंड ट्रैपेज़ियम एंड एट लास्ट काइट दीज आर फोर मेन क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स बट ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ सम स्पेसिफिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम पैरेललोग्राम कैन बी क्लासिफाइड एज अ रेक्टेंगल पैरेललोग्राम एंड रेक्टेंगल आर सेम ओके रोम्बस एंड स्क्वायर आर सेम बट ओनली फ्यू स्पेसिफिकेशन इज डिफरेंट ओके वी आर गोइंग टू टेक पैरेललोग्राम एंड रेक्टेंगल इन अ वन पेयर रोम्बस एंड स्क्वायर इन अ वन पेयर ट्रेपेजियम एंड आइसोसेल्स ट्रेपेजियम इन वन पेयर एंड काइट इज कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट अबाउट फोर ओके so the next topic is parallelogram okay parallelogram guys what is parallelogram a closed entity by covered by four sides a closed entity covered by four sides are known as parallelogram but we know that the meaning parallel means parallel something is parallel so what is this what is it sorry what is it parallel means parallel something is definitely parallel but what is it that means sides are parallel guys I'm writing in the points okay all the specification about quadrilateral I'm just going to write all the points in points okay first opposite sides are parallel and equal opposite sides AB and CD are parallel guys the sign of parallel is 11 not 11 two vertical lines okay this is the sign mathematical sign of parallel not parallelogram parallel okay and the sign of parallelogram is parallelogram I hope you understood okay now opposite sides are parallel that means AB parallel to CD and BC parallel to AB equal AB equals to CD and AD equals to CB okay now next we know that four sides two diagonals are formed diagonals are only bisect to each other now draw the diagonals diagonal 1 and diagonal 2 at a point 2 what is the meaning of bisect the meaning of bisect bi means two sec means sections divide any figure any line any object anything into two equal parts is the meaning of bisect diagonals are bisect to each other at a point o That means DO equals to BO. Okay, OD equals to OB and OA equals to OC. Okay, this is the meaning of bisect to each other. Okay, opposite angles are equal. Very important. Opposite angles are equal. That means angle A equals to angle C and angle B equals to angle D. Okay, this is about only parallelogram. Okay, now I'm going to take the sum of all interior angles in a parallelogram, or you can say the sum of all interior angles in a coordinate. Okay, we will take further later. Okay, we will take later. It's I think it's covered 15 minutes, so we'll take later. First, we complete this one. Okay. Now, rectangle. Everyone knows ninety. Okay, opposite side. Are equal and parallel. Sorry. All sides are perpendicular to each other. All sides are perpendicular to each other means we have two line segments, that is the meaning of perpendicular. 90 degree, the angle formed between two lines is 90 degree. This is again 90 degree. This is again 90 degree. This is again 90 degree. Okay. So the mathematical symbol of perpendicular is line and this is the 90 degree. This is the mathematical symbol of perpendicular. Each angle 90 degree. Sum of all interior angle 90 multiplied by 4 360 degree. We will prove how is it 360. We will prove later. This is a rectangle. A very important diagonals are only bisector. Only bisector as compared to the parallelogram, but the different thing is all sides are perpendicular to each other. Okay, next rhombus. What is rhombus? Rhombus and square are same. Rhombus and square are same. Only one term is different. Okay. Now, rhombus. What is rhombus? All sides are equal. All sides are equal. This is rhombus. All sides are equal means AB equals to BC equals to CD equals to DA. All sides are equal. Diagonals are perpendicular bisector. That is the important point. That is the important point. Diagonals are perpendicular bisector. That means when you plot the diagonals in rhombus, diagonals are perpendicular but also bisector. Perpendicular bisector. They form 90 degrees at the intersection point. You can see 90 90 90 90. Okay, yes or no? AC is perpendicular on BB. I told you, na, this is the sign of perpendicular. Okay, and same AO equals to OC and OD equals to OB. Perpendicular and bisector. That is the meaning of perpendicular bisector. Okay. Again, sum of all interior angles. Sum of all interior angles. 360. Right? In any kind of quadrilateral, the sum is 360. Sum of all interior angles. Interior 360. Square. Same concept. All sides are equal. Everyone knows. All sides are equal. So 90 90 90 90. All sides are equal, but the different thing about regarding rhombus is all sides are perpendicular. All sides are perpendicular bisector. Sorry, perpendicular to each other. Same diagonals are perpendicular bisector. Diagonals are perpendicular bisector. Okay. This is about square. Now, where is my marker? Just give me a second. Next is trapezium. What is trapezium? Very important concept, guys. What is trapezium? One pair is parallel. One pair of side is parallel. Guys, one pair of side is only pair and parallel. I am not talking about parallel and equal. Only one pair, any one pair. AB parallel to CD. That's it. Okay. AB and BC are non-parallel sides. Okay. This is trapezium. Isosceles trapezium. If non-parallel sides are equal, The non-parallel sides AD and BC are equal in length, equal in measurement. That time it becomes an isosceles trapezium. Okay, you can check AD equals to BC. This is isosceles trapezium. Next is kite. Everyone knows the kite, na? You fly the kite. Same concept. Kite is look like. This is your kite. Adjacent sides are only equal AB equals to AD, BC equals to CD. Okay, one of the diagonal bisect perpendicular is perpendicular bisect to another. Only any one diagonal is perpendicular on other but also bisect. This is the meaning. Okay, here O, so OB equals to OD only. Okay, this is right. Last topic, angles and property. Is it visible? What is angles and property? Sum of all interior angles. The sum of all interior angle is n minus 2 multiplied by 1 interior. Way of n is number of sides. Guys, you have number of sides n. Like in quadrilateral the number of sides is 4. In quadrilateral the number of sides is 4. Okay? In quadrilateral the number of sides is 4. Okay, that means 4 is the number of sides. Okay, so the sum of all interior angles in a quadrilateral is 360 degree. I told you how it comes. Just put it the value here. Quadrilateral n equals to 4 minus 2 multiplied by 180 degree. 360 degree, you can check. Okay, this is the use of this formula. This is the use of this formula. But an important concept, sum of all exterior angle is always 360 degrees. Guys, the important concept is the sum of all exterior angle, either way it's octagon, either be it's pentagon, hexagon is always 360 degree. Always 360 degree. Okay, this is the first concept. Second concept, sum of one exterior and corresponding interior. Is 180 degrees. We know that one exterior angle and corresponding interior is 360 degree. How? Look at here. Okay. If this is 30 degree, if this is 30 degree and this is 50 degree. Find x and y. Find x and y. Okay, we know that this is you can say this is rectangle. Okay, this is a rectangle. Okay, guys, the one thing you should always know, without if you don't know the name of the figure, you cannot find the angles. Like, if I don't know what is this figure, if it is not mentioned in the question, this is not a parallelogram, rhombus, any kind, you cannot find all the angles. How? Okay, but if I told you this is parallelogram, rhombus, no, parallelogram. Okay, this is a quadrilateral according to the sum rule. 30 plus 50 plus 70 plus x equals to 360 degree. We know that 120, 150 plus x 360 degree. So x is 110 degree.